Now that we know the definition of slope, we're going to talk about what slope means, what the slope of a line tells us about that line. We're going to start off right here. We're going to graph the line through the point negative 1, 2 that has the slope 2 thirds. Now we can think of slope as rise over run, the amount you go up divided by the amount you go to the right. Another way to think about slope is the change in y divided by the change in x. So here, the slope is 2/3. So for every 2 that y changes, x changes 3. So y goes up 2, x goes up 3. We rise 2, we go to the right 3. We see our line right here. So just given a point and the slope, we can use those two together with what we know about slope to graph the line. Now I'm going to change this problem just a little bit. All I did was drop in a negative sign right there. We're starting at the same point, negative 1, 2, but now the slope is negative 2/3. Let's see how that changes the line. As before, we can start off with our old slope is rise over run, the amount we go up divided by the amount we go to the right, and that is negative 2/3. What does that mean? I'm confused. I mean, can a line even have a negative slope? Well, let's think about that first. Let's think about how a line could possibly have a negative slope. And then we'll go back to graphing that other line, if we can. So here we've got the definition of slope. Difference in the y-coordinates divided by the difference in the x-coordinates. So let's see if we can make a line that has negative slope. So we're going to start with that point right there. We're going to start with the point 2, 1. And we want to combine that with some other point and get a line that has negative slope, if we can. Well, I'm going to choose my second point somewhere up here where y equals 4. So I'll go ahead and pick the y-coordinate as 4. And then my slope be the difference in the y-coordinates divided by the difference in the x-coordinates, whatever that is, minus 2. Well, now we got to choose what that is. Now if we pick over here where the x-coordinate is greater than 2, like if we pick 3 or 4 or 5 or 6, then the denominator here will be positive. Numerator is positive. Positive divided by positive, the slope comes out to be positive. So if I pick any of these points out here, I get a line with positive slope. So that has positive slope, that does, that does, that does. Those all have positive slope. But look what happens if I pick a value of x that's less than 2. I pick one of these points over here. If I put in 1, for example, I'll get a negative denominator. Numerator is positive, so the slope will come out to be negative. Same thing for any of these other points. If I put in negative 3 down here, denominator is negative, we get a negative slope. So for any of these points back here, I'm going to end up with a negative slope. So these over here are all positive, upward sloping lines. These all come out to be negative, downward sloping lines. We can go ahead and look at an example of that. Go ahead and put in that point right there, negative 1, 4. Slope comes out to be 3 over negative 3. We get negative 1, and sure enough, we have this downward sloping line. So now we know what to expect to happen back here. And we can make more sense of why this should have happened back here by thinking instead of rise over run, think of this as change in y divided by the change in x. That's what the slope is. And I can write this negative 2/3 as negative 2 over 3. So y changes by negative 2, that means y goes down 2, while x increases by 3. Down 2, increase by 3. We can also think of that in terms of rise over run. If the rise is negative 2, well, if the rise is positive, we go up. If the rise is negative, we go down. Down 2 to the right 3. Also could have thought of this as 2 divided by negative 3. So y goes up 2, while x goes down 3. Y goes up 2, x goes down 3 means we go to the left. We end up over here. And sure enough, there's our line. And, as expected, it's downward sloping. So we see positive slope, upward sloping. Negative slope, downward sloping. What about a vertical line? What's the slope of a vertical line. Now let's go ahead and look at a specific vertical line. Let's look at this one. All right, there's our vertical line. Let's take a couple of the points on it and find the slope of the line through those two points. So the two points we have here are 2, negative 1, and 2, 3. And we'll just use our definition of slope here and find the slope. Difference in the y-coordinates, 3 minus negative 1, divided by the difference in the x-coordinates, 2 minus 2, which is 0. We can't divide by 0. I mean, should I pick a different 2 points? Oh. Every point on this line has x-coordinate equal to 2. So no matter what 2 points I pick, my denominator is going to end up being 2 minus 2, 0. We're not allowed to divide by 0. So we can't do this. The slope... We say that the slope is undefined because no matter what 2 points we choose on any vertical line, their x-coordinates are going to be the same. So the change in x-coordinate is always going to be 0, can't divide by 0. So we say that the slope is undefined. We don't say that the slope is 0. The slope is not 0. The slope is undefined. And the way we describe this line, well, every point on this line has x-coordinate equal to 2. This is the graph of x equals 2. So if someone came to you and said, hey, what's the graph of x equals negative 1? You just find this vertical line right here. This is where all the points are whose x-coordinate is negative 1. All vertical lines look like this. They're x equal to something. Takes care of a vertical line. You know what we're going to talk about next? Horizontal lines. We'll do the same thing. We'll start off with a specific one and think about that. Grab a couple points on it. And we'll find the slope between these two points. These points are 2, 3, and negative 3, 3. So we find the slope between these two. And once again, we have the difference in the y-coordinates divided by the difference in the x-coordinates. And, well, the y-coordinates are the same. And that's always going to happen for any two points on this line. Both of the points will have y-coordinate equal to 3. So when we take the difference in the y-coordinates, we always get 0. And this will happen for any horizontal line. Any horizontal line, all the points on that line have the same y-coordinate. So the difference in y-coordinates will always be 0. The slope will always come out to be 0. I bet you know how we're going to describe that line. Back here, we describe vertical lines as x equals to something. Over here, for our horizontal lines, this is going to be y equals 3. These are all the points with y-coordinate equal to 3. All horizontal lines will be y equals some number. So we've gotten taken care of the horizontal lines, taken care of the vertical lines. Got just a little bit more. Here we have two lines, a red line and a green line. They both have positive slope because they're both upward sloping. Which one has the greater slope? And we'll look at what our definition of slope is. The amount y changes divided by the amount x changes. The rise over the run. Here the amount y is changing is much more than the amount x is changing. We go up a lot more than we go over. So if we go up a lot more than we go over, we expect the slope. The slope here is greater than 1. Now the green line, we go up much less than we go over. We go up much less than we go over. So the green line, the slope is less than 1. Of course, makes us wonder, what does a line look like if the slope is 1? We go over and up the same amount. Go over 1, up 1. Over 1, up 1. Over 1, up 1. And the line with slope 1 looks just like this. We're going up and we're going over at exactly the same rate. When our slope is greater than 1, we're going up faster than we're going over. The line is steep. When the slope is less than 1, we're going up more slowly than we're going over. The line is flatter. So, quick recap. Positive slope, line slopes upward. Negative slope, line slopes downward. Vertical line, no slope at all. It's undefined. We say that there is no slope for this line. The slope is undefined. We don't say it's 0 because the slope is 0 for a horizontal line. And finally, we can use the slope to figure out how steep the line is. If the slope is really close to 0, then the line isn't very steep at all. It's pretty close to flat. If the slope is 1, it's going up just as fast as it's going over. And then if the slope is very large, then the line is very steep.